Happy Monday, everybody. We're here at Athlete Central. Great to have you guys. Let's get our workout on. We got our spacing down, keeping our distance. We all use our hand sanitizer. If you're at home, we're gonna jump in with something that we haven't done yet, which is juggling. If you just wanna work on your touch, you wanna work on just your overall skill and having that ball be like your best friend, juggling is a great way to do it. We're gonna turn it over to Coach Mike real quick. He's gonna get it started. Coach Mike.
Good morning, boys and girls. Welcome to a new week. So we're just gonna go really, really, really simple. And all we're gonna do is work on right, left juggling. And we're gonna try and keep it beneath knee height. Ideally, there's not a lot of spin in the ball, so it's not coming back into your shins and your knees. So we're trying to keep it using right on the laces just to keep the ball going back and forth. And we've gotta try and do right and left. So we're trying to keep it low. Making sure that when the ball comes up, we're trying to keep the least spin off it as possible. I've had an absolute nightmare then. We're just trying to keep the ball nice and low, little spin as possible. Try to stay in one spot and keep your feet moving quickly after each touch to keep the ball moving. Yeah, if you want to, if this is a little difficult for them, right, left, we can go right, bounce, left, bounce, right, bounce, left, bounce. Even for a bit more fast feet, if you see my feet from the side on perspective, quick step down as we're moving the ball. Quick feet, touch, quick feet, touch, quick feet, touch, quick feet, touch. That's a little bit of variance to it, even for the more advanced players. And then we can go back to keeping the ball low. Right, left, quick feet, in between.
Perfect, Coach Paul. Thighs.
So we'll do exactly the same, just gonna use our thighs. Our aim is to keep our back relatively straight. We don't want the ball going over the level of our eyes. Change feet every time, or change legs every time. It's just nice and soft. So again, we want our back to be somewhat straight. Nice and soft touches, and then we'll go up. My feet land nice and soft. See if I can get at least 20. If I can't, slow it down. Back nice and straight. Nice and soft touches again. The lower I go, the less reaction time I have. The higher I have, the less control I have. So I want to strike that kind of happy medium in the center. See, I'm trying to level with about my nose, big nose at that, and I get past 20. That's my aim for today. Set a record, as I say to everybody. Try and meet your record. That's what this is about. Nice and soft. Last go. Definitely last go. Okay.
Perfect. Let's jump right in with three variations on jumping jacks. Everybody knows a basic jumping jack, but I'm going to teach you two new ones that you might not know. Let's do sets of 20 of everything. Start out with the basic jumping jacks. 3, 2, 1, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. T-jacks, your hands start together, you hit a T, they go apart. Set of 20, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Cross jacks, check this out. Left over right. Right over left, both upper body and lower body. Again, left over right, right over left. Go, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Perfect. Let's do those again. 3, 2, One, from the top, jumping jacks. 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. T-jacks. Set and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. Cross jacks, remember. Left over right. Right over left. 3, 2, 1, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Perfect, quick little stretch. Rotational lunge. Left leg forward, right leg back. Go ahead and get your forearm down. Hold that for about 10 seconds. Following your thumbnail, rotate as far as you can. Let's hold that for 10 seconds. Okay, stare at your thumbnail. Now the weave position. Again, stare at your thumbnail. Reach this way. Try to apply pressure from the back of your hand against the ground. Next side, holding those three stretches. Just the forearm position. Okay, getting nice and low. The more I squeeze this left hip, it helps to loosen up the front muscles, the anterior muscles of your hip flexor. Follow the thumb. Twist, twist, twist. Stare at that thumbnail. And knees. Again, stare at your thumbnail. Okay, back to the first side, 5 repetitions. Hold each position for at least 2 seconds. Follow your thumbnail. 1, 2. And weave. 1, 2. There's one. Rotate. 1, 2. And weave. 2. There's two. Rotate. And rotate. And last one. And rotate. Perfect. Next side, same thing. Great stretch to open up flexibility through not only your hip flexors, but also your torso, your core. Stare at your thumbnail. And big rotation. And rotate. Apply pressure from the back of your hand against the ground. Last two. Perfect. From there, take your fingers, interlock them, and we're gonna do an overhead squat for a set of 20. Fingers interlocked, okay? Arms are straight up. You wanna have your hips go back and down, down for 2 seconds, up for 1, 3, 2, 1, go. And up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. 5. Keep it up. Keep it up. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Halfway. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That's 5. Come on.
Let's go. Here we go. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Perfect. From a plank position, alternate forward reach. Hands are down. In fact, go ahead and start in a push-up position. Hands to your armpits. Push yourself up. All your weight goes forward. Now, try to avoid any kind of twisting. Don't twist at all, okay? No twisting. Right arm up and hold that for 3, 2, 1. Next side. Left arm up. 3, 2, 1. Let's keep going back and forth. 10 total reps. Here we go. Right arm up. What's this do? Increases your stability through your core and your shoulders so that you're gonna be a strong and stable athlete. Left arm up. Good. Back to the right side. Switch. Halfway, 5 more. Switch. Good. And one more. Sweet. Let's go back to juggling like we started off. Coach Mike, let's go and go just feet base like last time.
Okay, we're reverse this time, so we'll do forward balancing. And again, focus on the quick feet activity within it. And again, even if you can do a million juggles at once, this is still good to keep yourself moving. So I'm gonna go forwards first, and we're gonna take the ball left and right, so we can change directions with the ball while it's bouncing. So 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm gonna go left, right, back right. I'm gonna come back. I'm gonna go forwards. And left. And right. So just a different way of doing it. And then when we can get the ball going, we go a little bit faster trying to keep this record. Regardless of what it is right now, trying to keep the ball in the air beneath the height. Like so. Last piece, you only get a bit more advanced than that. And if you don't, it's totally fine, but if you do, you start to go low, high, low, high. Okay, that's a little tougher. So, right, right, left, left. Right, right, left, left. Keep your feet moving in between times.
You know what I like about that, what he was just showing, is you have to stay on the balls of your feet. You can't be flat-footed when you're playing. So often, we'll just kind of scan how people are training. You'll see somebody flat-footed. You know they're not going to get to the ball as fast as they can. You have to be in that ready position. And sometimes just working on simple footwork like this or juggling, it reinforces the fact that you're always having to stay on the balls of your feet so that you're ready to move as fast as possible. Paul, what you got?
Okay, so this time, we're just going to work on right first. So we're just going to work on right foot, okay? So we're just on our thigh, let it land. Again, look at my feet, I have to move a little bit faster now. Try and face forward as much as you can. It's always a challenge for me for sure. Once I've had 3 goes, can I now, without hitting the camera, just work on my left? And once I've had 3 goes on my left, can I now work on my right? So 3 on each, okay? Try and see what your record on your right, on your left is, okay? Rob, 3 on the right, 3 on the left. Off you go. Gotta be 4. You against you, not against anyone else. You beat 6. If you're me, you haven't quite done 6, beat that. Now onto my left, what can I get? Can I beat 1? Can I beat that score, whatever it was, my last score? Try it at home. You got a whole week to try and beat it.
I really like what he said just there. I think that is a technique that countless athletes have always utilized. Compete against yourself. Make it fun. Make it engaging. Make it a game. If you're right foot dominant, try to see if you can make your left foot perform just as well as your right foot, or vice versa. Hey, Mel, what you got as far as like a new skill for us? Maybe building off the cowboy kicker?
Hey, guys. So this week, as far as skill, we're trying to build a little bit off of last week. So Paul and I kind of came up with one where it's working on bells, doing four touches, and then a drag. The good news is with four, it'll alternate every time. So it'll end on the foot that you want to drag it with. For example, one, two, three, four, it's on my left, so I'm gonna drag to my left. One, two, three, four, it's on my right, drag to my right. One, two, three, four, drag. One, two, three, four, drag.
Good, let's keep that up for 30 more seconds. 30 more seconds. Seven, six, five, four, three, two. Great stuff. Perfect. Let's get one more round of strength work. Going back to our overhead squats. Remember how we interlocked our fingers? Go ahead and interlock your finger. Biceps to your ears. Set a 20 again. Down for two, up for one. Three, two, one, go. Boom, and power up. Two. Three. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Keep that chest up. 11, 12. Good. Heels flat. 13, 14. Keep it up. 15, 16. 17, 18, 19, 20. Great job. Next drill, from a plank position, alternate forward reach. 10 total. Let's hold each one for at least 2 seconds. Totally flat, hands at your armpits. Press yourself up. Spread your feet out a little wider than hip width and right arm up. Sit. Sit. If you can, turn your palms up so you go above your ear. It makes it a little bit more difficult on your shoulders. Sit. 5 more. Keep it up. Last two. Great job. Perfect. Let's take it back to Coach Mike. Hey, Mike, building off of what you were doing last week with your skill work, what can we work on at home?
So last week we did a number of different skills that were keeping the ball tight to our body, protecting it from the defender. So we've done scissors, we've done step overs, we've done all step overs. So we're just putting a little combo. I'll do it really slow to start with. We're going to start with our bells. We'll just go 1, 2, 3, 4. Tops on top of the ball, 1, 2, 3, 4. Take a touch in one direction, I'll start on my right, outside the foot. I'm gonna turn my body to face where the ball's going. We're now gonna put in a step over turn. So again, I'm gonna fake to keep the ball into the goal, it's over there. Fake, step, same foot, come back. And then we'll restart. Then we'll go the opposite side. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Touch, step over, back. Reset. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Touch outside. Left step over. Come back to the center.
That's a great
touch.
Combo.
Keep step that. Over and go. And notice the ball's always going side to side. I'm using the orange going to the defender as I've done in the past. It's not going towards the defender.
Last two reps. Perfect. All right, Coach Paul, what you got?
So this one is going to make it a turn. So just like last week, a little bit of an emphasis on the step over that Coach Mike did. It's going to be two touches. So two touches here. One, two towards the cone. Bring my foot over. Outside brings it back. I change feet. One, two, over, outside brings it back. Now, soft touch on the ball. Outside has to bring the ball back. As your foot hits the floor, transfer your weight and your speed to go that way. One, two, roll and out. One, two, roll over and out. One, two, and let's go. Change feet every time.
Nice.
Turn the direction, tuck your toes to pull back that way. Can you face this way as long as you can? Then change. One, two, I'm facing this way. No, I'm not going either way. One, two, and over. Go on, let's speed it up. How fast can you do the turn? One, two, don't go past the cone if you can.
Last
one,
two reps.
And over, last one, got this.
I like that.
Okay.
Great, right. Paul, good stuff. Great stuff, Paul. Coach Mel, what you got?
Enough,
hurry up.
Then we're just gonna go back to kind of what Coach Graham was showing us, where it's a pull back behind your leg, take a touch, touch, pull back behind the leg, touch, touch, pull back behind the leg, touch, touch, pull back behind the leg. If you really want to bring in the fake into it, as we're taking that touch, touch, fake, pull back, touch, touch, fake, pull back. Find
more like
a choice. If you
want to
make it a little bit
more dance. Perfect. 30 more seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6. 5, 4, 3, 2. Cool. In soccer, I would say, similar to basketball, maybe even more so in soccer, your lateral speed, incredibly important. You have to be able to get left to right. Take your ball, go ahead and place it just to the side of you. Take four big steps. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is your A, that's your B. Okay? We're gonna do a set of four repetitions. All we're doing is there and back, but as fast as possible. Go ahead and make contact with your ball, make contact with your ground. 3, 2, 1, go. Boom, get there, get there. 1, get there, get there. 2, get there, get there. 3, get there, get there. 4, cover a lot of ground. Catch your breath, one more time, same thing. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. Get to that spot. Set and go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfect. System core work in there. We did this one last week. 2 hands, 1 foot. 20 total reps. Take your ball. Both hands to your left foot. Both hands to your right foot. 3, 2, 1. Go. 1. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, perfect. Rinse, repeat. Balls down, lateral shuffles. 1, 2, 3, 4. Low stance, get there. Set, and go. 1, 2, 3. Good, catch your breath, one more. Set. All right, here we go. And go. 1, 2. three. Swing. Fly it back. 20. Good job, everybody. Keep it up. Doing great. Home stretch. Arms overhead. And up. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Perfect. Catch your breath. Real quick water. Quick water, we finish up. Quick water, we finish up. Last challenge. It's not incredibly complex, but it is challenging. Let's hold a 1 minute plank, arms separated. The reason why you want to separate your arms as opposed to interlocking, if you interlock your fingers, look at what happens to my posture if I drop my arms. Somewhat rounded. You don't want to emphasize that. By separating your hands, you emphasize proper shoulder position, proper posture. Okay, so separate your hands to shoulder width. 1 minute. You got this. Here we go. Last thing. Three. Make a straight body line. Two, one, up. One, two. Six. You got it. Seconds in. Last 20 seconds. Fifteen, 14, 13, abs tight. 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and time. Great job. Perfect. Butterfly stretch. Good stuff. Mondays are not easy for everybody. Sometimes Monday's a little bit harder, but you gotta keep moving forward. Left foot, right foot, left foot, right foot. Okay, that's how you get your week started. That's how you get moving in the right direction. Is every workout gonna be amazing? Is every workout gonna be a 10 out of 10 as far as intensity? Not necessarily, but you keep progressing. You keep moving forward, okay? You keep challenging yourself, staying sharp. Keep the left leg where it is, right leg behind you. And fall forward. Great job. If you're at home, remember the coaching key for this, keep this hip flat. This is one of those stretches you can just, if it's something that's kind of tight for you, just work on it. Sit in it for, you know, multiple minutes to get everything to loosen up. And next side same minute. Perfect. See a little pike stretch in there. Point your toes. Legs are straight, point your toes down. Reach, little itty bitty slight bend in your legs, like 5%. And then finally, this one feels nice. Bring your right knee in towards your chest, take it across your body, let your lower back stretch out a little bit. And next side, same thing. Left knee in towards your chest, stick it across your body. You might get some back rest. All right, great having you guys today. Remember, you can check out these workouts also by YouTubing, looking up LA Surf SC on YouTube. Again, LA Surf SC on YouTube. Watch these throughout the week, okay? Look forward to seeing you again tomorrow at 11:30. Be good, you guys.